Hi, this is Jerry. We're going to be going over a storefront door repair with Kawneer pivots and how to retrofit a system in there for you. This is a maintenance call that we had received from our company. And this, as you can see, the bottom is a lot of rust down here. So that bottom pivot is definitely done. And the top pivot actually looked like it was in pretty good condition. But they come in a set and you don't replace the one without the other. Here I'm identifying and making sure, even though I know what they are, I'm showing you where to go for the screw holes and how to line them up to make sure that you have the right one. There's measurements right there. If you watch till the end, I'll have a part where I'll show you different kinds of pivots in the diagrams. But this one, I had one in the vehicle. And it is a standard Kawneer by identifying it, by setting it up there. I actually recognized this one because I've done them before. And I know that this top here, you have to retrofit it. It's not going to be a quick and easy fix, but the bottom, there's a screw top right there that you take out, and there's an Allen wrench underneath to adjust it afterwards if you need to. And I'm taking out the top here, that one of the screws busted out, and the bottom piece was welded on. I mean, from friction and from the ball bearings being gone, and it snapped right out of the threshold. And we try and leave that part in there because you an hour job, you could get this thing done if you don't have to replace the bottom pivot. If you do have to replace that bottom reinforcement pivot, it's can take you up to 3 hours instead of an hour. So here's the bottom piece, and I pre-put two screws on it because then I can slide it right on. By leaving it a little loose, I can slide it right onto the bottom of that, the bottom of the door. And you see where that top screw hole is. I have to put that last one in when I screw it on. The top was a little different. There's my retrofit on it. I had to do bigger screw holes. And they're in a different spot, and I'm mounting it to the door, and the top post pushes up and down, and that's for installing it. This is just a door closer that we did at the time, and this is the door bottom that I'm going to retrofit into the bottom. Now this is a neat trick that will save you a lot of time. I'm lining it up to make sure how far in it has to go. Then I put it next to the frame and I scribe it so that I have a mark. And then I cut it off with a die grinder and pry up the threshold there and pop that out of the way. It's going to leave you the reinforcement piece on the bottom that hooks the frame and that door together. And I drill it out several times along the bottom of there and snap that out in the same way with the screwdriver, and then just hit it to make sure that it's completely even so that I can get my threshold piece in there. It's completely out of the way, and the threshold piece just taps right in there. Put it up to the same spot that I had measured and screwed it down. Easy as pie. But it still took 3 hours, so now when you're getting this in, you're gonna have to pop that door in the bottom right there and push that top pin in and just wiggle it, and it'll pop right in there. You should have no problem getting it in. If you have a problem getting it in, then something happened and you got to go back and look at your measurements. Here, this is the retrofit piece that I used on the bottom to retrofit that in. And this is a different pivot that I wanted to show you. It's not handed. Most of these pivots, like this one, is handed. This one, I think, was most popular with U.S. aluminum, and this one was the Kawneer one that I used. There's about four that are really standard that you should kind of keep on your vehicles. This is one of the most popular ones that I use everywhere, but there are different hole patterns up top, so be careful on that.